Good morning, Virat. 11 years before, in Malaysia, in the Under-19 World Cup, the two captains are now the same captains in different tournament and the World Cup. Could you anticipate that, you know, this will repeat in 2019? And can you kindly tell us the journey?
No, not at all. I'll actually remind Kane also. I'm sure he remembers when we meet tomorrow. I'm going to remind him. It's quite a nice thing to realize that 11 years after, you know, we're captaining our respective nations again in a senior World Cup from Under-19. So, yeah, we've spoken about it before. A lot of players from that whole World Cup, from our batch, from their batch, from other teams as well, made it to their national teams and are still playing. So, which is, I think, a great thing to see. I think it's a really nice memory, and we'll both feel good about knowing that, you know, this is happening. And it always seems no one could have, neither me nor him could have ever anticipated that, you know, one day this will happen. But yeah, it's a really nice thing. I got Kane's wicket.
Yes.
Did I? I don't know if that can happen again now.
Yeah, Virat, how's the mood in the side, and how did you guys react to the last minute change in travel plans from Leeds to Birmingham instead coming here?
We were very happy because it was only 1 hour compared to 3 hours in the bus. So very happy with the change in travel, and Manchester is a great city to be in also. So all the guys were very happy. The mood is great. Everyone's very relaxed, very confident. And look, all the teams worked hard to get to these moments. And now, you know, whoever plays better on the day, we know that things are as simple or as complicated as that. So we're all looking forward to it. It's been a long tournament. It's been a lot of hard work, a lot of intense games. So, yeah, we're really, really happy that we have made it to the semis. And now there's only opportunity that lies in front of us, and everyone's very excited for it.
Virat, when you remind him of the result also, Under-19, but on a different note. Is there a change in mindset when you approach a knockout compared to what you've played so far in terms of the 9 games of the pool stages? And if so, how does the team sort of prepare for a knockout and you have no chance to slip?
Well, it is a little bit different, if I have to be totally honest. League stages, when you know that you just need a victory to qualify, then the team is a bit more relaxed, and you know, you can go out there and try a few things. But I think knockout games, you need to be very precise, at the same time being intense. So I think that balance, this is more similar to, you know, the toughest situations you'll get in Test cricket, where you have to be absolutely precise, but your intent cannot go down. So I think decision making will be crucial, and both teams are experienced enough to have played these games. New Zealand was in the finals last time, and they know how to play knockout games. They've had a wonderful World Cup again, so the quality side. But yeah, on the day, whichever team is more brave in being calculative, I think that team stands a better chance to win. So yeah, we understand that combination. We've made it to a lot of knockout games and finals. So yeah, it's up to both the teams to bring their A game, and then whoever handles pressure better is the team that's going to come out on top. And we certainly are looking forward to doing that.
Virat, what's your assessment of the New Zealand attack? And how do you sum up the performance of the Indian attack so far?
Well, if according to me, I think our bowling attack has been up there with the best, if not the best bowling attack in the competition. I think the way we have bowled in low scoring games, even coming back into the match when the guys have been hit, I think we've shown a lot of character. And New Zealand attack has always been a very balanced bowling attack. Their pacers are very consistent. Mitchell Santner brings in a lot of control with his skills in the middle overs. So, yeah, they're a team which has always been a very consistent team. So we know that up against them, we'll have to be very, very disciplined. At the same time, we'll have to play very correct cricket to, you know, score runs against them, because they bowl in good lines and lengths, and they know exactly what they're doing. So we have to be absolutely sure of what we are doing. And that's the kind of challenge that team brings. They put the ball in the right areas and then, you know, make you play good shots. So it's going to be a nice battle. We've played against them a lot. But yeah, they're a quality side and a very, very potent bowling attack.
Virat, personally, you've never not been in a World Cup semi. So what was the mood like after the win? And you've seen both results too. So what is the win like? What is the mood like after the win in Mohali and after the loss in Sydney?
Very obviously very contrasting. The win in Mohali was my first World Cup, and you know we make it to the finals and playing at home, and the whole atmosphere was brilliant. So getting to experience that for me as a youngster was something magnificent. 2015, I was more of an established player, and you know not being able to get the team across the line was obviously very disappointing for all of us. But this time around, because the format has been different and we understand that the tournament has been long, guys have put in a lot of effort day in, day out, and then to realize, okay, we have achieved the first goal that we wanted to, which was to qualify for the semis. That gives you an extra boost of energy. Okay, now we can focus totally on these, you know, the remaining two games that we have in the tournament, and try to bring our A game and take up the intensity even more. So I think that incentive is very important to realize as a team that you have done what you wanted to do as a first goal. And now you can be even more, you know, intense and energetic when you step onto the field. So it just gives you a bit more energy knowing that we're entering the last phase of the tournament and bodies are not going to be as fresh. But then these kind of things motivate you even further to put in more energy. So we're quite happy after qualifying.
Virat, Rohit has got 500 so far. You know, it's unusual that you haven't got any. So are you missing the 100, you know, considering the consistency with which you get them? Are you missing a century?
No, not at all. I mean, it's been a different kind of role that I've had to play in this World Cup. And as the captain of the team, I've been open to playing any kind of role that the team wants me to. So it's great that, you know, Rohit is scoring so consistently, which means that coming in the later in half of the innings, you have to play a different role, which is controlling the middle overs and letting guys like Hardik and, you know, Kedar and MS in the past few games and now Rishabh come out and express themselves. So I've understood that, you know, roles can vary a lot in one-day cricket, depending on the time you step into bat. And I've been very happy with holding one end and, you know, letting guys express themselves, striking at 150, 160 or 200 if the team needs. And then I know I can accelerate in the end. Personal milestones, honestly, is something that no one ever focuses on. Rohit said the same thing the other day. He's only trying to do the best for the team. And then in that process, special things happen, which is something that I've always believed in my career so far. And I could never imagine that I could get the number of hundreds I have. And the only focus has always been team. So I think playing a team sport, you need to be able to adapt. And I'm very, very happy doing that role. And I hope he gets two more so that, you know, we can win two more games, because it's an outstanding achievement. I've never seen anyone get 500s in a World Cup, be any tournament. So World Cup is all the more pressure, and he's just been outstanding. And as I said, he deserves all the credit. And according to me, he's at the moment the top ODI player in the world.
Virat, just back to the 2008 under-19 game. I know you said that you didn't envisage you playing off against Kane again, but did you see him at that time as being a future superstar, and how crucial is getting him out early to you guys winning the game?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's not even 2008. I remember 2007, we went to New Zealand, and we were playing you know, an under-19 test match, and he played a shot off one of our fast bowlers who was quick off the back foot. And I remember standing in slips and just telling guys standing at slip, I've never seen anyone play a shot like that. And he was special, along with a couple of more guys which didn't make it, surprisingly. But he was always the standout player. And you could see even when we played New Zealand in New Zealand on that under-19 tour, and then, yes, the World Cup again, he was quite special for them. So we always knew he has the special ability to go all the way. And now he's, you know, controlling the tempo of the game for New Zealand every game that he plays, and he's contributing so well. And he's a lovely guy. We get along very well. So, yeah, he's always been, you know, the main guy for them, along with Ross, who have performed really consistently. So I think those two guys have shared the load so far, and a lot will depend on them, obviously, because they've been playing well. And according to us, from our team point of view, getting both of them early will be crucial, because we know how strong they can be together in a partnership. So, yeah, it's not to mention here, but Kane and Ross are probably their main guys in the batting lineup.
Virat, the pressure on your team to perform is immense. I guess it's similar to the New Zealand All Blacks team at a World Cup. But how do you think Indian fans would feel if India lost at this stage in the tournament to New Zealand?
Exactly the way New Zealand fans would feel if they lost. So it's quite natural. I mean, everyone feels disappointed when you come to a stage of the tournament like this and you don't make it through. But look, yeah, the Indian team always carries a lot of pressure and expectation wherever we play, and we're quite used to that over the years, to be honest. So yeah, we're better off. I think we're better equipped to react well in these situations because we know what these kind of games and our fan base and the expectations bring. So I think disappointment is equal on either side. I wouldn't agree if you say New Zealand won't be disappointed if they lose. So yeah, but our aim and our focus is obviously on winning. And as I said, whichever team plays better will win.
Virat, your fifth game in less than 2 weeks. You've been traveling a bit as well. So what have you done to retain your physical and mental freshness?
Well, again, this turnaround was very fast. After the last game, a day of travel, today one practice day. So guys, depending on the workloads, which is provided by our trainers and physios, we understand which player needs to take a break from practice because having played so many games, you don't necessarily need to go hit balls again because you've practiced so much, you've played in the middle as well. And same for the bowlers. I mean, it's about staying fresh now, mentally understanding that your body feels good and you know, that mental cushioning that you have, knowing that you can put in all your energy on game day is very crucial. So I think adjusting according to your schedule in terms of taking off from practice and managing rest days is the most crucial thing. And that's something that we've done well, and that's why our energy levels have been able to stay right up there. You know, guys not coming for optional practices and stuff has really helped because you can easily come to practice and exert yourself and not recover in time. So, yeah, I think those things are very, very crucial, especially when you're on the road so much in between games as well. And I think we've managed it well so far.
Skipper, hi. We played New Zealand quite a few times in the recent past. But how different it is when you play an opposition in a bilateral series and in a World Cup game?
Well, you know, for the Indian team, every game is full of pressure. So we've never felt like any game has been easy for us at all. I can't remember the last time I stepped onto the field and felt like, oh, it doesn't really matter what happens in this game. For the Indian team, there's always full stadiums and people expect you to do well. And, you know, there's always pressure as well as opportunity. So as I said, we are well equipped to handle those kind of situations. But yeah, I think a World Cup knockout game brings that much more attention and excitement on the outside, and the atmosphere is going to be very different from a bilateral series. So just to be able to soak that in and still focus on what we need to do is going to be probably going to be the only challenge that we face in terms of, you know, it being different from a bilateral series. But otherwise, you have to play good cricket to win a game of cricket, and that's been our focus this World Cup. And I don't think we would change that because it's a knockout game. It's very important to treat it as a game of cricket and do what we are known to do.
Hi, Virat. As a batting unit, you guys pride yourself to be very flexible, and we've seen that over the last 2 years. And there have been a lot of changes in this tournament. Rahul moving up, Shankar, Pant, you know the changes. How would you describe the evolution of your batting lineup in this tournament and how it has impacted the way you have batted personally?
I'm glad you didn't say, is it the ideal 11? but jokes apart, yeah, look, as I said, I mean, having played 10 years, 11 years in the team now, it's my responsibility to play a role according to the team's needs. And I've been very happy if I walk in a situation where I understand that, you know, I need to play in a certain manner. I'm open to do that because if you're one-dimensional in your thinking, then I've walked in a few times literally as a number four. So I've had to control the innings in the middle overs, and I've learned so much in this World Cup along with, you know, spending time in the middle that, okay, this is also a role that you're supposed to play. And when situation arises, then you have to do that for the other guys to go and express themselves, knowing that one end, you know, I'm controlling an end and holding it till the end. So yeah, it's been nice. It's been a different kind of a challenge for me, and I've really enjoyed it, just rotating strike and understanding how to play in those middle overs, allowing the other guys, as you said, to come out and express. Hardik's come at four, now Rishabh's batting at four, so these guys can really come out and strike from ball one, knowing that they have a lot of batting behind them. And I think to go a long way in a tournament like this, you need to be flexible. especially going with the situation of the game. You can't have a set batting order from ball 1 to ball 300 because a lot of situations change. And I think we've handled it well. We've gone along with the pace of the game, and that's why we've won the number of games that we have. And we intend to do the same. I mean, if the situation presents itself where the opening partnership is outstanding and someone needs to go at 3 and strike the ball, it's absolutely open to do that. So to win a tournament like this, you need to be very flexible and think on your feet. And I think we've done that well so far. And hopefully we can do the same thing in 2 more games.
All the teams, all the matches here have been won by the team batting first. Are you worried that the toss might be too important? I know India have chased well on occasion, but why do you think batting second has been so difficult for so many sides at this World Cup?
Well, it comes back to the same point, handling pressure. You make two bad decisions while you're chasing and the game goes away from you, too far away to pull it back. So I assume that that's going to be the case because, you know, having been in so many chases, I understand that the pressure can be very high if you don't go with the pace of the game. And then understanding the magnitude of a tournament like this, you're probably going to end up making a couple of mistakes and the opposition's not going to let you off after that. So, yeah, look, we're not worried about the toss. It's an uncontrollable. You can't really predict what's going to happen at the toss. We have to be prepared both ways, and we're quite open to do that. And if it is a factor, it is a factor. So we can't say if we lose the toss, we have no hope, because we should believe enough in ourselves as a side to overcome any kind of situation. So I think all teams prepare in that manner. But yeah, it's a stat which I think is connected to pressure and not the pitch, to be very honest.
Virat, the last 2 games you played with 5 bowlers, there was no fallback option. Given that this is a knockout game, is there a chance of revival or reviewing the plan? And is there a chance the 2 wrist spinners coming back together again?
It's quite possible. Yes, we played with 5 bowling options because it gives us a bit more depth in batting. And mentioning the toss factor as well, if you're chasing a big total, then you need a bit more depth in batting. So yeah, we played with 5. We are up to reviewing that. Otherwise, you were just told I got Kane out, so I can bowl anytime. You know, I'm quite lethal as long as I don't slip on the pitch. So yeah, but having said that, It's open for discussion because we need to be very balanced with what we take into the field. At the same time, we need to make sure that the batting is deep enough for us to be chasing a score and being solid about that also. But yeah, 5 bowlers has worked well, but it's up for discussion.
Virat, there's been a lot of talk of Mahi, the batsman. I want to talk about Mahi, the personality in the team. This might be his last World Cup for all you
Thank
know.
Thank you.
What is it? I'm not talking about the pressure. What is it like, the mood in the camp? Yesterday he celebrated his birthday. I'm sure you guys would have celebrated. How much does it weigh on you as a captain and the dressing room's mind on Mahi, this being his last World Cup? What is it that do you want to kind of give him? Like, you gave a good statement about Tendulkar in 2011 after winning the World Cup. Is there something special that you would want to send him off with?
Well, I didn't prepare that one in 2011, so I'm certainly not going to write anything down. But yeah, look, I'm sure everyone, if you ask them, you know, about him, they have special things to say. And especially for us who started our careers under him. For us, that doesn't change. The respect will always be there because of the opportunity that he gave us and the faith that he showed in us. And the way he's handled the whole team in transition over so many years. And now we are the ones who are, you know, taking Indian cricket forward. We understand the importance of that process. So I'm glad you asked about MS, the personality, because a lot has been in focus otherwise. But yeah, look, when a person has done so much for the team, you have to appreciate and acknowledge what he's done for Indian cricket and how he's handled Indian cricket and taken the respect for Indian cricket so high all over the world. So yeah, from that point of view, we're all very grateful for what he's done for Indian cricket and for us. And he's always been in a very happy, jovial mood all the time whenever we see him. And yesterday was again a very, very happy moment for him, for the whole team, just to see a smile on his face. And he's in a very comfortable, very happy space at the moment. And I'm not thinking of anything apart from that, because the main focus right now is to do what we need to do tomorrow, and then you know, on to another one hopefully, and yeah, just have a good World Cup. But from the respect point of view for MS, it's always going to be sky high, especially in my eyes, because I know how difficult it can be to make a transition of captaining also, you know, within the same team, just playing as a player after being captain for so many years and still not, you know, being too assertive or too pushy in anything. It gives you space to make your own decisions and, you know, to actually discover yourself. So I think that's been his biggest quality. But at the same time, I go ask him anything, he's there giving me an advice, and he's never shying away from that. So, getting a call? Okay. So, yeah, he's been outstanding, and I'm really delighted that I've been able to play for so many years alongside him.
Virat bhai, हम सब देखते हैं कि उसेन बोल्ट जैसे एथलीट जो कि ग्रैंड प्री इवेंट में जिस तरह से दौड़ते हैं, ओलंपिक फाइनल में अलग दौड़ते हैं, लियोनेल मेसी आम लीग मैच में जैसे खेलते हैं, चैंपियंस लीग के फाइनल में अलग खेलते हैं, दुनिया के सबसे बेहतरीन जो बल्लेबाज है वो भी क्या ऐसे ही सोचते हैं इस तरह के मंच में कि कुछ अलग खेले, कुछ स्पेशल करे जो पहले नहीं किया?
नहीं, हर मैच में अगर आप कोई मुश्किल सिचुएशन आती है तो माइंडसेट यही रहता है कि आप टीम के लिए अच्छे से अच्छा खेलें और एक स्पेशल परफॉर्मेंस दें ताकि टीम जीत सके. और भले वो लीग मैच हो या सेमीफाइनल हो या फाइनल हो, उसका प्रेशर ज़्यादा होगा, तो क्योंकि आपको इतने सालों से प्रेशर हैंडल करने का एक्सपीरियंस है तो आप उस चीज़ को लुक फॉरवर्ड करते हैं कि अगर कुछ प्रेशर सिचुएशन आएगी तो मैं टीम को निकाल के लेके जाऊंगा. तो आई थिंक वो मोटिवेशन रहनी बहुत ज़रूरी है और वो मेरे दिमाग में हमेशा से रही है. और अगर अपॉर्चुनिटी सामने है टीम को एक स्पेशल परफॉर्मेंस देने की तो ज़रूर आप उसके लिए हमेशा रेडी रहते हैं, लेकिन आप प्रिडिक्ट नहीं कर सकते, क्योंकि अगर आप बोल्ट की बात करें या कुछ और बात करें तो एक वो सेट पैटर्न है कि उन्हें भागना ही है. बट क्रिकेट में जैसे मैंने बोला बहुत वेरिएबल्स होते हैं. अगर आप ऐसी सिचुएशन में जा रहे हैं जहाँ पे जल्दी विकेट गिरी या बाद में आपकी बैटिंग आए तो आपको एडजस्ट करना पड़ता है. तो बट मोटिवेशन वही रहता है कि जो भी सिचुएशन आए मैं टीम को एक स्पेशल परफॉर्मेंस दे सकता हूँ, वो कोशिश पर नहीं रहती बात, तो आपको कन्विंस होकर जाना पड़ता है मिडिल में. तो वैसा मेरा माइंडसेट हमेशा से रहता है.
विराट, शिखर को जब चोट लगी थी तो एक कंसर्न था ओपनर्स को लेके. केएल राहुल ने जिस तरह रन बनाए हैं बहुत ज़्यादा अटेंशन उनको नहीं मिली है. एज अ कप्तान और नंबर तीन आप उनके रोल को कैसे देखते हैं?
बहुत ज़रूरी रोल है. थोड़ा उन्होंने शुरू में स्लो स्टार्ट किया जो अंडरस्टैंडेबल है, पहला वर्ल्ड कप खेल रहे हैं और एकदम एक दूसरे रोल से ओपनिंग रोल में आ गए, जो कि बहुत वेल इक्विप्ड हैं वो करने के लिए, लेकिन एक टाइम लगता है एडजस्टमेंट, मेंटल एडजस्टमेंट एक करने में. तो थोड़ा खुल के अपने आप को एक्सप्रेस नहीं कर पाए पहले कुछ गेमों में. पाकिस्तान के अगेंस्ट बहुत अच्छा खेले, बांग्लादेश के अगेंस्ट बहुत अच्छा खेले, पर जो उनका खुद का एक स्टैंडर्ड है जैसी वो बैटिंग करते हैं वो हमें लास्ट मैच में और बांग्लादेश वाले मैच में ज़्यादा देखने को मिली. तो अपने रोल में और कम्फर्टेबल होते जा रहे हैं और अब उन्हें समझ आ रहा है कि अब ये एक अपॉर्चुनिटी है एक यंग प्लेयर के लिए, पहला वर्ल्ड कप खेलना और स्टैंड आउट परफॉर्मेंस देना एज एन ओपनर, स्पेशली नोइंग कि एक एक्सपीरियंस ओपनर आपके नहीं खेल रहे हैं. तो एक फ्रॉम अ टीम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऐसे दो स्टार्ट बैक टू बैक आपको 150 रन के मिल जाएं तो बैटिंग लाइनअप को लगता है यार कि हम बहुत एक सॉलिड फीलिंग आती है. तो आई थिंक उनका रोल इतना हाईलाइट नहीं हुआ, आपने सही कहा, लेकिन रोहित के साथ वो पार्टनरशिप को बनाए रखना, स्ट्राइक रोटेट करना और मेक श्योर करना कि वो लंबी पार्टनरशिप हो टीम के लिए, उसके लिए उनको भी बहुत क्रेडिट जाना चाहिए. और वो बहुत अच्छे फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड में है, जैसे आप उनको IPL में खुल के खेलते देखते हैं वो उस सॉर्ट ऑफ जोन में अब मुझे लगता है कि वो हैं. तो अगर वो चल जाते हैं तो फिर आपको पता ही है वो कैसे खेल सकते हैं. तो आई थिंक उनके लिए ये स्पेशली ये सेमीफाइनल मुझे लगता है वो बहुत लुक फॉरवर्ड कर रहे हैं और उनका जो सबसे एक्सप्रेसिव गेम है वो शायद हमें देखने को मिल सकता है.
विराट, इधर विराट, ये प्रोसेस की बात हमेशा टीम मैनेजमेंट करती है, लेकिन हम पहले से देख रहे हैं कि टीम रिलैक्स लग रही है, खुश लग रही है, प्रैक्टिस और कैसे बोलते रिकवरी का टाइम अच्छा दे रहा है. ये सब करना कितना आसान होता है, कितना मुश्किल? क्योंकि हर बार ये वर्ल्ड कप क्रिकेट की बात न करना ग्राउंड के बाद, ये सब के बारे में ज़रा बोलोगे डिटेल में?
देखिए सर, पहले दो हफ्ते तो हमने काफ़ी डिस्कशंस करे, काफ़ी क्रिकेट के बारे में बात होती रही, आपने मैचेस भी बहुत फॉलो किए, लेकिन एक वो मेंटल जो एक रेपिटेशन और एक फटीग है वो सेट इन होने लगता है. तो मैचेस के बाद काफ़ी लोगों ने ध्यान नहीं दिया दूसरे मैचेस पे या क्रिकेट के बारे में बात करनी नहीं चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर आप वही चीज़ बार बार डिस्कस कर रहे हैं तो मेंटली आप थोड़े ड्रेन भी हो जाते हैं उस चीज़ से. तो आई थिंक प्लेयर्स ने भी इक्वल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ली, मैनेजमेंट ने भी बहुत अच्छी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी हैंडल करी, ट्रेनर फिजियो उनके लिए भी बहुत मैं उनकी तारीफ़ करूँगा क्योंकि उन्होंने बहुत अच्छे से मैनेज किया हमारा वर्कलोड। जो हम GPS ट्रैकर पहन के खेल रहे हैं अभी, अगर वो हमारे पास नहीं हो तो आपको बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है कन्विंस करना कि एक वर्कलोड कितना है प्लेयर का, लेकिन अगर आपके पास डेटा है तो आप बोल सकते हैं नहीं इसको 48 आवर्स का रेस्ट चाहिए ही। तो आई थिंक वो छोटी छोटी चीज़ें हैं जो बहुत मैटर करती हैं, और अगर आप जीत रहे हैं तो फिर और चीज़ें रिलैक्स हो जाती हैं कि अगर आपको ऑप्शनल प्रैक्टिस में नहीं आना है या आपको अगर गेम के बारे में नहीं सोचना है तो फिर भी एक वो कुशन मिल जाता है कि यार हम अच्छा खेल रहे हैं, हमें सिर्फ अपनी परफॉर्मेंस पर फोकस करना है। तो आई थिंक हमने वो बैलेंस अच्छा क्रिएट किया है और तभी इंटेंसिटी हमारी नीचे नहीं आई है अभी तक मैचेस में। तो ट्रेनिंग, अपना रिकवरी हैबिट्स जो हैं, फिजियो ट्रेनर का जो फीडबैक है, सारे फैक्टर्स इंक्लूडेड होते हैं उसमें, उसके अलावा ये बैलेंस बनाना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है। तो हमने अभी तक अच्छा किया है वो, लेकिन अभी कुछ दिन और हैं तो और उसको हमें थोड़ा प्रिसाइसली करना होगा फाइनल तक पहुँचने और जीतने के लिए।